Mckin.
Cynthia McKinney, the former Georgia congresswoman and Green Party presidential candidate, was on the West Coast after returning from a fact-finding mission to Libya. McKinney made a previous trip to Libya in February before the U.S. and European-backed rebellion against Muammar Gaddafi's government broke out.
I was in Libya just literally days before the outbreak. It was almost as if they were waiting for us to leave. Muammar Gaddafi had called together all of the Africans in the diaspora, Africans from the continent, to come to Tripoli and talk about the dignity of humans, of Africans, and the human rights of Africans as they are being mistreated and abused in the European setting, in America, and wherever else we happen to be. And I had a lot of people with me in that delegation who had never been to Africa before. And actually, honestly, even though I've been to Africa, I don't know how many times, it was the first time I had seen, he had all of the kings there. So I saw African royalty all there with Muammar Gaddafi, with all of these other African princes and princesses and average activists like me, and we were all there asserting the dignity of African people. It was so beautiful to be there, but he, even at that event, said, he also announced $90 billion to the African Union for United States of Africa. $90 billion he announced at that event for the to see the fruition of a United States of Africa. He said, though, that there's trouble in the East and there's trouble in the West, and of course there was sure to be trouble in Libya because Libya was certainly a target. He knew that. And as soon as we all left and Tripoli was back to normal, that's when we learned that Tripoli was indeed a target, that Libya was a target. Now, one of the things that I have learned to understand is the deep gut, not just disappointment, it's almost a hatred that I have for the special interest press, because they are lying, actively lying to us. What? So I happened to be there on the night that NATO did their intense bombing, what they called intense bombing. That was 26 to 29 bombs. And well, that was kind of earth-shattering for me, because I never experienced anything like that. And you could see the missiles going over. You could hear the bomb. You could feel it. The hotel shook. Some of the windows broke. But when something happened, which I can't remember now, and then NATO started bombing during the daytime, and it was nonstop from 11 a.m. to 11:30 p.m. There were 89 bombs. In fact, they bombed so much that NATO ran out of bombs. And Canada is now in the process of acquiring 1,000 more bombs to continue with the program. Now, everyone is asking, why is this happening? The appropriate question is not only why, but what are we going to do to stop it? Everyone here must take note of what is happening in Congress right now. And Congress must exercise its authority and rein in this president.
Yes!
If this president proceeds, now we already know that this president is guilty of committing war crimes.
Yes!
We know that. Now, if having oral sex is an impeachable crime, certainly war crimes and crimes against humanity are also impeachable crimes.
Right.
Ignoring the War Powers Act and the Constitution is an impeachable crime.
Yes.
If President Obama refuses to heed public opinion in the United States, 60% of which is against the involvement against Libya, if he is determined to violate the Constitution and violate the War Powers Act and defy Congress, and I'm hoping that we will bring enough pressure to bear on our members of Congress that they will follow the House and in the Senate also vote to cut off the funding for this NATO operation.
Yes!
Because of what NATO is doing in Libya, what we're seeing is the Israelization of NATO policy against the people of Libya. Whether it's collective punishment, NATO now is refusing to allow food, fuel, and medicine to come in as they bomb people and hurt people. NATO is refusing to allow Libya to import the necessary medicine. That, too, is against international law.
Yeah.
That makes our president's actions also criminal in the collective punishment that is being visited upon the Libyan people. They can't even fish in their own territorial waters because NATO is stopping that. Sounds a lot like Gaza, doesn't it?
Cynthia McKinney and other activists have begun a national speaking tour to oppose NATO's bombing campaign.